I'm going to start with this picture. 2,500 years ago, Xenophon was the first Greek militarist who put this in writing to his soldiers. A good soldier will train the horse so the back can oscillate, swing, and come up. If the back come up, the haunches, the hind leg, can step further under the balance point. So the horse carries the rider and themselves more on the hind leg. So those very little legs, those tiny, tiny joints and ligaments and tendons are not as bent. If you have a shitty girth, a shitty balance rider, a shitty balance saddle, the horse will guard itself. Yes, form a girth. And all you need to do is have the wrong length girth. You could buy a girth for $30, will do the same thing. You can buy a girth for 495 euros. Ridiculous, almost 750 Canadian dollars. So the horse will go like this if you hit the horse on this point, that point, and that point. There's very specific points. I'm going into it a little bit later. So you have to ride for 20 minutes to make these nerve endings numb. But in the meantime, you ride with the horse hollow because that's how the horse guards itself. Remember, the horse is a flight animal. He's not going to fight against you. If the back is hollow, the back goes out, the hind haunches go out, and the horse lands hard, and his hind leg is not even close to the sternum. Guess where he loads? Bang, onto the forehand. There might be a reason why we have such an increase of horses with super, super problem in the front leg, lameness, rhythm problems. Now, is that all about saddle fitting, or does the girth maybe has a big part of it? Well, we talked about saddle fitting a lot. Today we talk about the actual girth. This is the absolutely collection. Now the sternum is, the hind hoof is underneath the sternum of the horse. And you can see there's a completely freedom in the front leg. This is your canter period. This is your moment before you jump. This is your sliding stop. This is the way the horse is ready to get to rear, whatever you want to do, okay? So the whole goal is you allow to open up the spine. If the girth, again, hits the sides, this is not gonna happen. Yeah, your horse will go like this and the hind leg goes here. So if we understand, I don't want my horse to go owie, owie and broken in the front, then I buy a girth the right length and the right shape and the right materials. However, in some sports, horses have to go like this. Somebody come up with the idea that the horse needs to have false elevation, hollow back, and go on the forehand. And sadly to say, $1 million prices are for these horses. Now, some girth are specially made for these horses. How do you, as a concerned owner, know, did you buy a horse for a girth for the horse to go hollow, or did I buy a girth for the horse to not get hurt? Well, hopefully, out of my little talk here, you'll be able to identify the difference between the right girth and the girth to get false elevation. If I look at the horse from the front, there's no neck, no vertebrae. You just look at the rib cage, the upper arm, the shoulder blade, elbow and sternum is one line. Everybody who rode a horse, what became light in front, hindquarters came underneath, you feel like the horse is growing underneath, the base of the neck comes up, and this horse is going beautiful up. And that's what happens. The horse lifts the sternum. Now, if the girth hits this muscle, this is a massive, massive and super important muscle. This is the upper arm, and this is the sternum. This is the pectoralis, so your chest muscle, your pecs on your arm, okay? So these muscles on the upper arm attached lift the rib cage. One more time. If your horse doesn't lift the rib cage, bang, there goes the forehead. So every effort is made for the horse to lift the rib cage once the back is freed up. Now, here are the two points which you're trying to avoid 110% with your girth. First, the most important part on the girth is the length. This muscle latissimus is attached to the fascia plate of the back and attaches to the upper arm, to this part of the horse's skeleton. Okay, so the latissimus comes from here and goes to the midsection of the back. On humans, the latissimus, okay, here's the edge. You maybe see people who do bodybuilding, and when they pose and they flex a muscle, they look like they have wings below their shoulder blade. So this muscle but comes out on the side. Let me remind you a little bit when you were in high school and somebody ran behind you and poked you in the side. They hit that side. And boy, did you jump. So if your girth hits, the buckle hit on this side, what do you think will happen? That muscle tightens, the back goes hollow. If the back goes hollow, hind leg goes up, and he will not bring his back up, and he will go like this. So if I want a girth, what makes my horse hollow and go on the forehand, I design saddles where the buckle is very sharp. I'm going to show you in a minute what I mean with the buckle is very sharp, or not protected. So I can hit that edge purposely, okay? Some people, I like to believe, 80% of people do not do this purposely. A very few in industries will hit that edge purposely. The girth has to be in the middle of that latissimus. You cannot sit at the edge of that muscle. That's the longissimus dorsi. The longissimus dorsi attaches on the four bottom vertebrae of the neck, goes under the shoulder blade all the way to the back. So the girth buckle cannot hit that edge. Very, very important. So when I look where my girth buckle can sit, right there. So what am I talking about? What type of girth would that be? Any girth what buckles underneath the flap. The safest bet for you is, it doesn't matter what saddle it is, it doesn't matter what material it is. If you end up in the last three holes from the top down, you're most likely right here where my mouse is. You never, ever, ever want to ride where your girth is on the last three holes or has a girth extender, a billet extender. Why is this area so bad? Why is that the worst part? Because that's the widest part of the horse's ribcage. Your leg pushes now the buckle against the horse. Your stirrup leather digs the buckle against the horse. So not only do we have this edge of the latissimus where the horse is tight, you're now also squishing the ribs. Make sure the buckle is girthed very high. Now for the western girth or for girth which are short. When I say short, I'm talking about cross country or jumping saddle, or most of the time you see it on jumping dressage saddle, where they have long billets. So the billets hang out underneath the flap. The average dressage horse is way taller than the average Western horse. Listen to this. The average Western saddle girth is way longer than the average English dressage girth. What's wrong with that sentence? Shouldn't the bigger horse have a bigger girth? Why do English riders buy too short girth? Oh, in case my billet stretch. Oh, in case the girth stretch. Oh, in case the horse loses weight. So that poor horse, most of the English girth, and I'm sad to say it, out of 10, there are 8 girth, they're way too short. See this edge here? Now we all learned in Pony Club, the buckle should never hit the elbow. But what you think is 10 centimeter, 4 inches above the elbow? It is that muscle I just showed you from the front, the pectoralis muscle. If the girth buckle sits on that edge, let me just show you one more time how important it is that you cannot sit. This is the pectoralis muscle. This is where the ribcage hangs off. Okay? If you irritate that muscle, he will never lift the ribcage. He will always bang beyond the forehead. I heard a saying the other day. People say, it's an old shiny saying. People who hear it will forget it. People who see it will remember it. People who feel it will understand. So if you really want to understand, and you're an instructor or saddle maker or retail shop, or you're a person who really cares for horses and want to educate people, ask them to do the same thing I'm going to ask to you. With your right hand, go towards your left armpit and feel that edge from your pectoralis. Now go with your fingertips hard back and forth over your chest muscle. Again, if you remember when you were little kids, people tickled you under the armpit. They tickled you right on this edge of the pectoralis muscle. Now, how annoying is that? Now, if you hurt yourself enough, you remember it tomorrow. So here you have your 450 euro dollar girth and the buckle sits on it. What a waste of money. You might as well get a $30 girth because that can hurt the horse just as much. So the length is super important. You want the length where 90% of all Western girth are. They're just below the latissimus. Why are they just below? Because they're below the widest part of the horse's ribs. So now the buckle pulls away from the body, the stirrup leather, the leg, the fender. There's no pressure on the buckle. Because when you look at the horse from the front, you have to remember the rib cage, okay? It's the widest on the side. Unfortunately, we have the shoulder blade in the upper arm, but just follow my mouse. It's wide here and then it goes narrow again. Maybe you can see it here. You see the rib cage, okay? So if you buckle just below the widest part, now the buckle pulls away from the horse. That little gap here from the front where my mouse is. Imagine the girth sits there. Imagine the saddle is on the English saddle girth where the Western saddle is. Why do you think so many Western saddles have the girth that long away from that edge and away from that edge? Not because they're maybe more educated than the English rider. It's because common sense. If they have to rope a cow or they go up and down and they're riding all day through the mountains and the saddle got to go left, right, and they don't want to have that saddle roll, the girth will hold the saddle way more in balance and in position because the buckle will never slide up when the saddle wants to roll and go over the widest point. It's physics. So if we understand physics, you get a way more quieter saddle if the girth is in the right area and the horse will not get sore. So that was, and I spent a lot of time on this for you guys to understand how important it is that the length, it's way more important, than the material or any other item on the girth. So now I would like to talk a little bit about what people want to hear. What is the best girth? There's so many designs of the girth and so on and so on and so forth. First of all, I'm going to look at this area here. Okay, so all these points, okay, there are acupuncture points, the bladder meridian points, BL, bladder meridian point 13. This is the lung reflex point. If your saddle slides forward, the horse gets an elevated heart rate. So big deal, I train harder. No, because if your horse gets an artificial elevated heart rate, we know it out of the human medicine, that means the horse has more cortisol level. Cortisol is how we measure if a human or an animal is in stress. So if you want to get your horse through unnecessary stress, make sure you have a shitty girth and a saddle girth what doesn't hold the saddle in place or your saddle isn't fitted. So the saddle girth can play a lot of role here. Then we have other points what all relates to the respiratory health to the animal. So if we know these points, okay, then we need to ask ourselves, if a horse moves, and you can see where this rider sits, it's a little bit back, so the girth would be just in front of the knee in that area, and you can see how the muscle gets wider and narrow, wider and narrow. 9 out of 10 saddles, the muscle what connects shoulder blade to upper arm, the tricep muscle, they'd contract for the leg to lift and then go forward. So here you can see the contraction. Okay, and here you see the shoulders go back. So people sometimes buy really expensive girths because the trainer said so, or this is the latest fashion, or it has a beautiful ad, and people go for it. I cannot remember as a child when there was only one girth around. And to this day, I haven't seen Western girth with elastic. We have universities around the world who do extensive research on the spine, taking the spine out, have machine hammer down to see at what point does the spine break. At what point do we damage the capillaries, closure, what do we get kissing spine? I mean, the knowledge people have now, what wasn't there before, all of a sudden we have girth designed so special and the horse has new problems we never seen before. Blisters on the withers from a girth. Rotated vertebrae or rib supplication from a girth. Really? I want you to think outside the box just for a second. Okay? When I have a structure, a saddle sitting on the horse's back, and over the withers is the most force. Here you see the cross-section of the withers. You have the latissimus, what takes the most load without the horse being super, super sore or damaged. That was the muscle what run front to back, what I showed you earlier. Okay, so that's that super strong, long muscle run underneath the shoulder blade. So we got that. And then we have this area, the wither, the trapezius, the rhomboides. If the girth sits properly without causing so much pressure that we have heat spots, dry spots, or pinching the withers, the easiest answer for me to give to you is think about your helmet. Okay? You're going to look at this here now and say, what does this diagnostic tool has to do with the helmet? Maybe I show you this picture first. Maybe you have a horse and you change the girth and all of a sudden the behavior changes in the horse. But at what stage do you know that your horse all of a sudden has really problems breathing? That's where this tool comes in. So this tool here, the newer types, they just have a sleeve. This app is for free. And then you can measure your horse's heart rate. And the first time I saw that in the simplest way with a heart monitor was a Dutch team member who was testing equipment, because at that stage the wildest girth came out. I mean, I'm going back 15 years. And the most expensive girth, believe it or not, showed the worst results. Why? Because it had too much elastic. People say, what? Wouldn't be elastic good? Well, let's go back to the working horse, to the horse really need to perform a long, long time. Okay, which most of the time is the Western horse. You won't see a Western saddle with elastic girth. You won't see it. The Western horse moves just as much as this horse. Okay, there's the contraction, shoulder blade goes back and forth. But if the saddle fits correctly where the rider sits, and through proper fitting, it eliminates the pressure on the shoulder, now comes the part where I want you to think outside the box. Think about a helmet. For you guys who are at my age, approaching 60, and you've ridden all your life, you probably remember those velvet helmets, those typical English caps. They were horrible. They were either too tight, they were very heavy, they were super hot, and they're slipping, and then they had this elastic band around the chin. Didn't hold that girth, helmet at all. And if the horse was bucking, the whole helmet tilted and broke the nose. And if you flew off, the helmet flew further than you. So today we have helmets that are super light and super comfortable. And the chin strap is a little different. But the shin strap is barely touching your chin. Only in the jerk moment when the horse throws you or bucks you, comes that chin strap into action. The whole time you can talk and you can chew and your TMJs are soft. Now bear with me. The girth is the chin strap. The helmet is the saddle fit. A good helmet, what fits the horse, the human, the rider's head, doesn't need a tight chin strap. So tighter the girth, so worse the performance of the horse and you're running into respiratory problem. So when the girth with elastic got invented, the worst thing ever happened to these animals. All the girth with new elastic caused the elastic girth, causes huge problems with breathing. Now you can say, who am I to make comments like this? I don't make comments like this. I'm reading papers. I'm reading what veterinarian studies and show. I'm using very inexpensive tools, what you can buy anywhere from $19, or you get the expensive tools where you can pay up to 750 euros. Right now you get these girth for way, way cheaper, for 290 euros. But my point is, data doesn't lie, right? Other stuff is just opinion. So if I buy a saddle girth and it's super, that's the latest, and this team developed it and became champion, an Olympic champion, blah, 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 right? And everybody buys it. And then I put this tool on it and the horse is in severe pain and has breathing problem. So I'm gonna ask you a simple question. If we look at the horse's body, I'm gonna change my camera just to show you something. Or like my dad, who was a German featherweight boxer, and we boys had to go in boxing. And he said, well, when you box, you want to protect your solar plexus. Well, guess where that is? At the end of the sternum. You do not want to poke your, or push in your gut just below your sternum. So okay. Mary Claire, can you...
I can't see your camera.
I just want to say, tell me when you can see the camera.
Okay, perfect. Yeah, we can see it now.
Can you see it now?
Yep.
Okay. All right. So here we got a horse. So believe it or not, there's girth made. So the hip and the horse's solar plexus. So this is exactly what we're trying to protect as boxers, because if you get punched out in here where the sternum plate ends, your lights go out as a boxer. So don't you think, when you look at the horse's rib cage, okay? So if you have a girth, what is made to push here on the ribs, which are not together, okay? What do you think happens here if I put pressure there? They get squished. And then girth comes forward and a very high point of pressure, huge amount of pressure on the very narrow spot. So you got this shoulder relief girth, but brings it back. I don't know, you can see this vein here. The picture is too bright, maybe. You can see that nasty vein. Maybe I find a better picture for next time. But we have a horse, okay? We have a girth. The buckle sits here, then it comes forward, and the front of the girth flaps in the wind. You can literally put a tennis ball in the front of the girth, right here. But in the back, you can't even get a fingernail in between. So if I share my screen again and show you, just to reiterate that one point, what I showed you earlier, okay, I want you to think. Maybe the Chinese medicine knows something about acupuncture. And maybe that's one point right there, CV17, which is not to play around with. Just saying, maybe some people know more about comfort of the animal by knowing a little bit about medicine than some top rider or designer or saddle maker. So if I listen to doctors who studied years and years about the equine health, Why would I risk girth what makes a spine hollow? If it's purposely written because I believe on pulling on the face and poking in the side, or is it because the girth sits on the spot what makes a horse hollow? Sure, you can do spinal surgery. Of course you can. But you can only maybe sever the top, but all these problems with these holes where the nerves come through, right there, when they get smaller, that's, you can't operate on that, right? So I cannot emphasize enough. Listen to nature, because this horse has no more chance. And these poor Arabs who are so strong and they're forgiving and they go forever, the body's just seizing up, okay? Many horses, they just give up. They check out. Okay, go ahead and hurt me. Most people don't want to hurt the horse. So what I want you to think about when you buy the next girth, I want you to make sure you go ahead and do the following. When you have the girth up, I want you to stick your hand in front and in the back, and you want to see if the girth has even pressure, okay? I want to make sure that the girth hangs straight over the sternum plate. If the girth has this logic girth or the shoulder relief girth, I guarantee you, you have massive pressure. Either it's pushing purposely behind and then is totally away from there. Okay, so I leave it up to you to use your common sense. So now the girth sits in the right area. But then you say, but then the saddle gets pulled forward, okay? You are not adjusting your chin strap to make your helmet fit. If the helmet doesn't fit, you're not cranking your chin strap on your helmet. Now, girth, elastic. My recommendation, no elastic. If you go elastic, it gotta be 3-ply. 1, 2, 3. On the jumping girth, never more than this distance. What is it, 2.5, maybe 3 inches at the most. The best test is if you can pull it apart with your own strength, it's the wrong elastic. The second you girth this saddle up, this girth up, and the billet goes through this buckle, the second it goes through it, it becomes a lever action. So the elastic is all of a sudden easy there. If this is elastic, it's easy with your hands, then you overgirth your girth. I give you an analogy. When do you think the horse gets panicky? When it feels no more, it's not able to take breath anymore because that girth is getting tighter and tighter and tighter. I'm coming back to the story in a minute. On the dressage girth, no more than an inch. Elastic should be visible. Less is more. 3-ply elastic. It should not move if you pull it by yourself. Soon as on the horse and you use the billets, you have a lever action. And you have it very, very easy to actually feel, oh, there is elastic. But I guarantee you, with the girth elastic I just showed you, you will never over-tighten the girth. Now, I told you about this Dutch technician who tested all these girths. And they saw that the girth with too much elastic increased instantly the heart rate. Here is why. Horses have, like other animals who are not predators, horses have a defense mechanism. That means if I feel threatened or I feel not in control, I'm starting to panic. Think about how this boa constrictor kills their prey. It wraps itself around the animal, and every time the animal exhales, what do you think the snake is doing? Tightens to the smaller rib cage. Now the animal wants to inhale but can't expand the rib cage. So he just takes half a breath. Now exhales, now the snake goes tighter. The snake is very strong, but it doesn't squish the air out. It just goes tighter and tighter while the ribcage goes smaller and smaller until the animal can inhale. A girth with too long elastic, longer than I just showed you, it will do the same psychological effect to the horse. How can I tell you this? Because we tested it every time. You don't believe me? Buy for $19 a heart monitor, try it yourself. When I started riding, we all had a string girth. Super cheap, very inexpensive. And when it's tight, it's tight. But we never over-tighten it. Unfortunately, majority of the people over-tighten the girth because the saddle doesn't fit, get these very false advertised girth. Ooh, nice and comfy for the horse so the horse can breathe while you ride. Would you buy a helmet what is long, long chin strap, and every time you lick or every time you chew, that jaw gets pulled in the direction you don't desire? Not only are you dizzy when you ride, you also will get a headache when you ride. Because your TMA, your jaw muscles, they all get tired because the chin strap on your helmet, it's irritating the snot out of you. No pun intended. So my point to you is, if you buy girth, think about helmet. The girth is only there, just with the cowboy or with Western saddle, to hold the saddle in position when there is a jerky move. A good girth is almost not touching the horse. It holds it in place. Think about your chin strap. You have a beautiful ride, but you know if you fall off, that helmet will stay. Not like the old helmets. So if we understand that a girth has enough room to allow this move, okay, while the saddle sits quiet, you don't need to have a girth what is tightening and loosen, tighten and loosen. Okay? You need a girth what is there in the moment of explosion when the rider is off balance or the horse has to kitty cat himself over this fence. But that's about it. You asked me to take long time to answer the question. I did. Here again from the bottom of the horse's sternum. Do not make the pressure go super tight here and super loose here. Have it nice and even, and hopefully that explains the questions from the girth.